Once I was bound by sin's galling fetters, chained like a slave, I struggled in vain. But I received a glorious freedom when Jesus broke my fetters.
Victory in Jesus. Open it up with some victory.
$398
in the 10th hymn. 398.
I guess that's not 498.
Oh, yes. Let's all stand up.
I
Amen. Amen. Good to see all of you here this evening. Oh my goodness, the last evening of August 2013. All right, we want to invite everyone back tomorrow, you know, for our Sunday morning service, if you're able, and Sunday evening service. We're going to begin a study in the book of James. We're going to go through for 16 weeks. Just in case you don't know, there's about 16 weeks left in this year. Going quick. All right. We always want to go to the Lord in prayer. I hope you started your day and end your day in prayer before our Lord and Savior. Do we have any special prayer requests? Do we want to remember Brother Jim Maxwell as he's home finally from the hospital? I want to remember Tammy, the whole family.
She's got tendonitis, real bad tendonitis. Sure she does.
Vertigo.
I
remember Sister Debbie, who was home with vertigo.
Okay.
Someone over here? Amen. Yes. Yes, Brother Brandon's uncle passed away. And now the funeral will be Wednesday morning at 10 in Auburndale. Sister Lucille? Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Any other prayer requests? Josh? Amen. Absolutely. It's all the unspoken. Amen. We have unspoken on our heart. All right. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, we've assembled this evening. Lord, we've assembled together to worship and praise you in song, in words. But Lord, our hearts are lifted up to you. We thank you, Lord, for your blessings upon us. Thank you so much for these people that have come out this evening. We ask your hand of presence truly be upon them so they know without any shadow of doubt it was good to be in the house of the Lord this evening. And Heavenly Father, I lift the church up to you as a whole. We thank you for this wonderful, loving church that continues to reach out to this community and to the world. Lord, we ask your blessings upon the gentleman who's coming to sing specials and also each one who are singing, Lord, in their own way and in their own desire to worship you, to praise you. And Heavenly Father, we thank you for each one. Be with these that have been mentioned, Lord, many sick. Be with the families of loved ones who've gone on to be with you. But again, Lord, we ask your healing hand upon not only these that have been mentioned, but upon each and every one of us. But again, we thank you for all your blessings. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a seat. Well, I'm going to turn all those festivities over to Brother Brandon, and you got the list.
Okay, can you give me one favor? Can you make a copy of this real quick? Oh. Before I get it started? I forgot about that.
Oh.
All right, I heard we had an anniversary. Smokey and Helen, was it your guys' anniversary or coming up?
That I heard?
Guys, would you guys just stand up?
Yeah.
All right, we'll sing happy anniversary to you guys.
You're not going to stand up.
How many years? How many years has it been?
22.
22? Did you guys stand up
for us? Y'all can turn around and stare at him now.
Yeah.
Come on, Teresa into doing this with me because I'm so bashful. Y'all know that. But when you walked in tonight, I was watching a lot of you, and you had this little sourpuss look on your face. I mean, frowning, holding your head like you had a headache. And look where we are. When you walk through those doors back there, you should remember what we're here for. You should remember that we're here to sing praises to the Lord. So tonight, we're going to let you do just that. Teresa's going to sing because I don't sing. That's why she's up here. Teresa, what blessing did you have today? Did you have, but I know you had one from the Lord today.
I got up and I made it all through the day without a headache, and I'm here tonight.
Thank you, Lord. And I know each one of you would say you had a blessing from the Lord today, but what did we do for him? So we're going to sing this little song. If y'all grew up in church, you all know it. If you're happy and you know it, say amen. The second verse is, if you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. The third verse, now this may take some of you some doing. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. Then, if you're happy and you know it, do all three. So I want to really hear you, and I don't want one frown in this congregation. I want to hear you singing. Even Brandon up here is going to sing. Okay.
And I want y'all to stand up because it's a lot easier to stomp if you're standing. You can't do this song standing down. And anybody that wants to sing louder than me, go for it.
Okay.
If you're happy and you know it, say amen.
Amen.
If you're happy and you know it, say amen.
Surely show it.
If you're happy and you know it,
say amen.
Amen.
Clap your hands.
And you know it,
clap your hands.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, then your life will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands.
Stop your feet.
If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet.
Say amen.
Amen.
And stomp your feet.
If you're happy and you know it, do all three.
Amen.
If you're happy and you know it, then your life will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, do all three. Amen.
Yay. I don't, preacher, I don't see him. One of them frowning now, so I guess we're good.
She found the music to another one, but we're not even going to try that one. Tammy knows it. Some of y'all others do. I'm in, right out, right up, right down, right. You have to not only stand up, but you have to get out in the aisles because you end up kind of dancing with that one, so we're not going to do that.
Well, we got it going. Let's keep it going now, okay?
All right, first on the list is Sister Mary.
And I'm going to start with the CD because it makes me the most nervous. And so, I do real well with her, but I don't do so well with CDs. And I hate that mic. It's not Peace. It's not Peace. It's number two.
Thank you.
guys like to try to open your mouth and this happens. And I'm sorry for that, but listen to the words. Never listen to me. Sometimes I'm on key, sometimes I'm not. This is an old standby. This is one Debbie and I were going to sing, but she's not feeling well, and she does have vertigo, and my mother has vertigo, so I know, I don't know what she's going through, but my mother knows what. That's got to be out of my way. I don't like it. But this is Farther Along.
Why it should be thus.
and your grandma in it. Especially when your grandbabies are here.
You'd come and share all my sorrows, and you said you'd be there for all my tomorrows. I came so close to sending you away, but just like you promised, you came there to stay. I just had to pray, and Jesus said, come to the water, stand by my side. I know you are thirsty, you won't be denied. I felt every teardrop when in darkness you cried, and I strove to remind you that for those tears I died. Your goodness so great I can't understand, and dear Lord, I know that all this was planned. I know you're here now and always will be. Your love loosed my chains, and in you I'm free. But Jesus, why me? And Jesus said, come to the water, stand by my side. I know you are thirsty, you won't be denied. I felt every teardrop when in darkness you cried, and I strove to remind you that for those tears I died. Jesus, I give you my heart and my soul, and I know without God I'd never be whole. Savior, you've opened all the right doors, and I thank you and I praise you from earth's humble shores. take me, I'm yours. And Jesus said, come to the water, stand by my side. I know you are thirsty, you won't be denied. I felt every teardrop when in darkness you cried, and I strove to remind you that for those tears I died.
It's like a storm that cuts the path, it breaks your will, it feels like that. You think you're lost, but you're not lost. I will stand. know your life on earth was trouble, and only you can know the pain. You weren't afraid to face the devil. You were no stranger to the rain. So go rest high on that mountain, 'cause son, your work on earth is done. Go to the Father and the Son. Oh, how we cried the day you left us, gathered round your grave to grieve. Wish I could see
when we sing the lift him up part, praise his name, cut it off.
The next on the list would be Jeff first. And then right after Jeff, we have Jeff Brandon.
For the ones that know me from my church, my dad was diagnosed with cancer of the kidney and also cancer of the pancreatic this month. And I wanted to find a song to celebrate a son's love for his father. But as I'm searching and searching the internet, I couldn't find one. Most of the songs are about a father's love for the son. Well, I came across this song that was written by a preacher for his dad, so I'm going to sing it now. It's called Thank You for Being My Dad. No, I recorded it off a video, so it takes a second.
Thank you.
Why you coming, Brandon? Get up here. Okay, the next song we're going to do is called Amazing Grace, My Chains Are Broken.
It's just so good to be here. You know, you make us feel so welcome at Beulah Baptist Church. We feel like this is our second home, and we just love coming here, okay? We thank you for your welcome, how you welcome us. And it's just every time Deborah say she's coming, we are all excited. We can't wait to get here. Okay, with that, I'm going to sing He Touched Me. Shackles by a heavy burden, beneath the road of guilt and shame, and the hand of Jesus touched me, and now I'm no longer the same. He touched me, oh, He touched me, and oh, the joy that fills my soul. Something happened, and now I know He touched me, and they me whole. Since I met the blessed Savior, since He cleansed and made me whole, I will ever praise Him. I'll shout where eternity rolls. He touched me, oh, He touched me, and oh, the joy that fills my soul. Something happened, and oh, I know He touched me, and made me whole. He touched me, oh, He touched me, and oh, the joy that fills my soul. Something happened, and now I know He touched me and made me
right there. Don't trip. Now we can. Put it right in front of Kathy. Let her. Put it right there. Is it very hard? Children, let me say something to you right quick, sweetheart.
Thank you. I love you.
Okay. What were the two things we talked about on the way over here? What are the two things that every man should always know when it comes to women?
Yes, ma'am.
And?
Yes,
ear. Mm-hmm. See, I'm teaching them. They're learning. And you never point out to a lady that she wore that last time. That's just not good.
Oh, no. I'm saying I'm going back.
Okay. We're ready when you are, Robert. Get me out of this. He's dancing back there. Do you see him? He is. He's doing the duck dance. Because this is a fun song and I have a good time with it. We're going to do it right. What?
Thank you.
Not making any of them. If they want to join, they can join. Sing through twice, okay? We'll sing through twice. Just wait for my count.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high.
Hey, you don't leave me hanging.
Yeah.
Where's my list? I lost my list. Oh, it's down there.
Shelby has requested me to sing.
I didn't, she did.
A cappella, I'll Fly Away. That's going to be the song they're going to sing at my funeral. She flew away. That's it. I'm changing the words a little bit. So if we don't do this right, we're doing it because we love the Lord, right?
Okay.
That's it.
Okay.
Some morning when this life is o'er, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. When I die, hallelujah, by and by,
Just to slow everything down here. I always like the second verse, being a preacher. The second verse speaks loudly to me, but I know it speaks loudly to everyone. This is just a closer walk with thee. Keep me from all wrong. I'll be satisfied as long as I walk, dear Lord, close to Thee. Just a closer walk with Thee, precious Jesus, hear my plea. Daily walking close to Thee, let it be, dear Lord, let it be. Through this world of toil and snare, if I falter, Lord, who cares? Who with me my burden shares? None but Thee, dear Lord, none but Thee. Just a closer walk with Thee, precious Jesus, hear my plea. Daily walking close to Thee, let it be, dear Lord, let it be. When my feeble life is o'er, time for me to be no more. On that bright eternal shore, I will walk, dear Lord, close to Thee. Just a closer walk with Thee, precious Jesus, hear my plea. Daily walking close to Thee, let it be, dear Lord, let it be. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be. Those critics. I'm trying not to imitate you. So. I'm just a poor wayfaring stranger, traveling through this world below. There is no sickness, no toil or danger in that bright land to which I go. I'm going there to see my Father. I'm going there, no no dark clouds will gather round me. I know my way is hard and steep, but golden fields lie out before me, where weary eyes no more shall weep. I'm going there to see my mother. She said she'd meet me when I come. I'm only going over Jordan. I'm only going over home. I want to sing salvation's story in concert with the blood-washed band. I want to swear a crown of glory when I get home to that fair land. I'm going there to see my Savior, who shed his precious blood for me. I'm only going over Jordan. I'm only going over home. I'm only going over home.
All right, Brandon and I are going to. This is a first. A little song I wrote a while back, and he overheard it and said, I think I can do that one.
I'm going to have to be right here just because of the time.
Remember, this is the first.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I remember.
Why did they nail him to Calvary's tree? Why, tell me, why was he there? Jesus the helper, the healer, the friend. Why, tell me, why was he there? All my iniquities on him were laid. He nailed them all to the tree. Jesus, the debt of my sin fully paid. He paid the ransom for me. Why should he love me, a sinner undone? Why, tell me, why should he care? I do not merit the love he has shown. Why, tell me, why should he care? All my iniquities on him were laid. He nailed them all to the tree. Jesus, the debt of my sin fully paid. He paid the ransom for me. Why should I linger far from his love? Why, tell me, why should I fear? Somehow I know I should venture and prove. Why, tell me, why should I fear? All my iniquities
iniquities on him were laid. He nailed them all to the tree. Jesus, the debt of my sin fully paid. He paid the ransom for me. All my iniquities on him. Jesus, the debt of my sin fully paid. He paid the ransom for me.
Show this off. Okay, go ahead.
You remember?
Now this song is just in fun. Take it for what it is. Fun. Okay? Count your wrinkles. Can you see it?
Show for all the sweat and tears and the
I'm coming to my song at the wrinkle party. Okay, so open your eyes. Now look, everything looks the same, like it was took. People making money off us like crook, like the pirate captain of the ship. Hook, Peter Pan plays Jesus. Look in the book, explain our lives and how our soul gets shook by the devil earthquake. Better stop playing hooky. But you might be a rookie, new to the game. Like you don't know how to play it, to believe, learn fast. If you don't know, just say he could put the truth on your soul. Just pray when it hits you, get baptized. Like washing hands from the sun, how Father Holy Ghost washes the sin. Like the dishes in the kitchen, always dirty again. Stop acting like the world a bunch of stupid twin. Learn how to quit the world marching band. Hold up, nah, just open your eyes a little. You might say that everything in this world is basically the same. Tune sounds a lot different, but they all play. Basically reenacts the world marching parade. Ha ha. Hold up, end of the world like a bunch of cars. With the same models might be a lot different, but transmission the game stick a modern wheel drive. Does the same thing, put the gears in motion. Either way, we got a transmission though. A soul gave to believe is your choice. I gotta say, better believe in the truth before that day when death comes and you chose. Whether you stay in a high chosen paradise, go through the gates to the streets of gold. If you ain't thrown the straight, and you know what that happens, pain will be the name of eternity for your soul. Nah, man, better believe. Only you to blame, and I heard that you chose that. Not to be a lame, you gotta change it before death. That's too late, you gotta learn how to quit or we're marching parade. Hold up, nah, just open your eyes and look. You might say that everything in this world is basically the same. Tune sounds a lot different, but they all play. Basically written it's the world marching parade. Ha ha, hold up, man. Okay, so now money ain't the root of all evil, it's the love, and you can't fly away. You ain't a duck, you just 9/11 red. Like us, but you ain't flying, you just plummet. Trust, if you don't believe in the truth, it gets rough now to this world. Might as well learn up the truth before it's too late. And they'll come like the wrong road you drove down. Be in a car, you might be a different model. Transmission, not what you have, it's called a soul. Don't get left in the dark by Satan messing with your mind. Setting you apart by the truth of the Son who paid it. By the truth of the Son who paid with the blood. Know that you can be saved, that's what it paid from. The Son. Jay, get right. The Son, Father, Holy Ghost. Not get dunked to be washed away from sin. Not love the one who paid for it all and got it done. Hold up. Nah, just open your eyes a little. You might say that everything in this world is basically the same. Tune sounds a lot different, but they all play. Basically written it's the world marching parade. Now see, y'all did two songs. I was gonna do two, but I can't. Y'all can be shame.
What's up? You can turn that one off.
I got this over here.
Testing. Give it a second. Now I hear it. It's an older unit, so it's all right. I tell you what, y'all have really, I'm serious, y'all have blessed me tonight. I have a few songs that I'm going to sing. And has anyone ever heard of Stephen Curtis Chapman? Of course, everybody has. Well, I sing a couple of his songs. I sing a little bit of everything. And seeing the word or the title Baptist out front here, sometimes that makes us ones that like a little bit of everything type of music makes us nervous, because this song is a little out there and it's a little loud, and it's one of the things, but it's a real true song. Okay, it's about being happy every day. This is an adventure that we are on. Grab hold of it and run it for all it is. Satan likes to play the cancer game, the sickness game, the this and that game, and he wants to bring us down. Why? Because the more we're down, the farther we can quit looking up to Him. The more we just get involved in everything. So, Wade said last week, you know, we was raised in the Baptist house. We wasn't allowed to dance and all that stuff. But I'll tell you this. When a song moves me, I move. I guess that's part of the Pentecostal that's in me. You know, I mean, we all have. I'm going to tell you right now, when the good Lord tells me it's time for me to go, I will not walk in a holy manner through the gates of heaven. I will be running full blast, and if you go at the same time as I do, we might have a foot race. If you win, that's okay. You know, I'm gonna hit them knees about halfway and slide in home. But God is so great and so awesome, and we've taken everything that we see every day, and it just packs on top of us, packs on top, and we go through life just, oh gosh. Sure, we want to get to Him, but we don't want to get to Him because, oh, it just stinks down here. It does, but He didn't intend for us to look at that. Amen. You see what I'm saying? He didn't intend for us to love Him because, okay, well, I've got streets of gold and a mansion and this, that, and the other, and hey. That's not why He wants us to be there with Him. He wants us to be there with Him because He gave His only Son, because He loved us so much to pull us from the sin. See, I don't want you being in that. See, so it gets me excited. You know, I'm not one of them long-faced religious type that, oh, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. I'm sorry. I'm happy. I am. I have days of sudden disappointments, and you know, I'll be 52 in December. I know that's young to some of you, but I've already started training with a walker. My wife says I'm doing pretty good. She's already got a reservation at the nearest home. You know, no, I'm kidding. But anyhow, I'm going to sing a few songs for you. These songs mean a lot to me, and I hope it speaks to everybody. That's the main goal of these songs. Now, my boys tease me when I'm going on a long trip. I like driving music. And for young people, you know what driving music is. I cannot play a guitar. I cannot play the drums. But I can play a dashboard, and I can play the air guitar. So you're about to see those things. This is the silly side of me. I'm just real. Okay, you ready? Listen to the words of the song, then. This better start. So far, so good. Breathe. This is the first time this has been in any church. Oh, I forgot one. I gotta put it over here. Now I've gotta do this. That's the introduction where I was gonna be talking. Ta-da! Yeah, it's like Superman's time. Got it over here. And His glory shone up. See, that's the way I am. Here we go. Listen to the words. I'm not singing by myself on this. Stephen's gonna help me out. He better do it right. Sunny out this morning, leaves were away. Take the thoughts inside my head of what I had to do today. Another's eye around a circle, trying to make it better than the last. I opened up the Bible and read about. with all the fun that y'all have had tonight, y'all gave me permission to be able to do that song. And the Wrinkle song, I want the words to that. I want to put it on a CD. I'm not here to, I don't have any CDs. So I'm not here to sell anything. Pastor told me, he said, you know, it's a week after, and we don't, no love offers. I don't care. I'm honest. I'm not kidding you. To be able to be here tonight is a blessing like you would not believe. To me, on so many personal, different levels. I sang with the Gulf State Quartet for 6 years. Was blessed to be able to travel all over the state of Florida and sing all different places, all different styles of different denominations of churches and everything. Lord led me that it was time for me to go on my own. Well, guess what? Sometimes the Lord says it's time for you to go on your own, but he didn't throw it in that, well, you got to wait a little while. I'm one of them that once I get on the starting gate, I'm ready to go. But he wasn't. He had things that he wanted me to do, had to learn, had things for me to go through. You see, when you do things for God, he has things set aside for you, yourself. Last week I did Elvis during. I've not done that in years. Okay. I probably won't do that tonight. It's one of those things. And here's the funny thing about this. When I was in high school, when I was in 10th grade, I was in chorus. I was raised in Southern Baptist Church. I was not taught parts to sing, you know. I always sing lead. So I joined the chorus class. And they're going around the class and they go, what part do you sing? What part? So the girls, I'm alto, I'm soprano. They got to the guys. Well, I'm bass, so I sing. And then they go into the, and they got to me, and I sing lead. Of course, now if you tell that to a trained professional chorus teacher, lead, we don't have lead. We have tenor, baritone, but I'm like, okay, I sing one of them. I don't know. I'll lip sync some of it. I don't know. You know, that's the way I was, seriously. But anyhow, they found out that I could imitate Elvis. And it was a joke. You know, fun for me. My dad loved hearing me singing in church. And I always did Elvis's great, you know, Southern gospel music, musical songs. I'm a nervous wreck right now. But anyhow, I'm trying to compact a whole service down in just a few short minutes. But here's what I learned. I had one of my friends, he said, you know, we got a talent show coming up. I'm like, yeah. I'm a shyer. Okay? There's one thing you don't do to a shyer. You don't dare him. He said, I dare you to imitate Elvis and the talent show. I'm like, huh? He said, I double dog dare you to do that Elvis and the talent show. So I'm in high school in 10th grade, and I'm like, okay, well, I can't do, oh, Lord, my God. They'll be like, huh? You know, you're in high school. So I said, I don't know what. So they taught me into doing blue suede shoes. So I borrowed a blue suede shirt, I had jeans, and the collar was flipped up. There is one fold of that. That's it. But I did the whole leg thing and everything. Here's what happened, and I learned a big lesson from it. That year, from then on through high school, everybody was, what's up, Elvis? How's it going, Elvis? I kid you not, I have 3 yearbooks. Elvis, it was great to be in class with you. Elvis, you're the coolest. I'm like, so here's what I learned. I say all that to get to this. I did that in 10th grade. I didn't do it in 11th, and I was like, I'm not Elvis, I'm Dale Shire. 11th grade, this is, or 12th grade, says, you gotta do it one last time. So I did, you know, blow me to, blow me to. It was cheesy. You know, and it was, you know, it was cool, but at that time it was cool, but now I think about it, it was cheesy. But I learned this. God never intended for me to be Elvis. I even had a guy offer me on a local bar in Auburndale. He says, I'll pay you whatever if you would come down and imitate him. And I'm like, well, I'm only so-and-so of age. I was like 17 years old at that time. He's like, oh, you can't do that. I'm like, well, I didn't really want to anyhow, you know, because I had already learned the lesson. I don't want to be Elvis. I want to be me. It's fun to imitate him, you know. And one of the things is I got used to doing, I'd be walking down the hall and, Elvis, what's up? What's up, man? How you doing? It's good to see you at school today, man. You know, I always make fun. It's like, can you imagine if Elvis had been like your weathercaster on the news? I don't know, it was part of the planet. A little bit of sunshine. I don't know what's going to rain. It might. But don't hold me to it. Y'all got my peanut butter sandwich back there ready? You know, that wouldn't work. Now, he would be a good Southern Baptist preacher. I'm not going to go there. Isn't it amazing how God didn't say, you know what? I'm going to make y'all complete, and I'm going to give you some sense of humor. Have you ever noticed? A lot of Christians have left their sense of humor. All of a sudden, they've gotten saved, and they're like, it's like they're in shock. Oh, my. I don't want to lose my halo, nor my wings. And they walk around like they're floating about 5 inches above the ground, where they're like, and it's like, some of them, they get that look on their face, they're like, they're hearing the, you know, all the angels. I want to slap them upside the head and say, get back to reality. We're here. We're still here. We have His presence and we have His Holy Spirit with us. And that's, I tell you what, that's the one thing if you're born again Christian, a lot of people just, they get scared of hearing about the Holy Spirit. One of the most important things to me is prayer. That is the time that I'm allowed to talk with Him and be in His presence. And He just, what's up? What you going through? Now He already knows. But see, He likes to hear our relationship with Him. Because He knows when we're contacting Him and talking to Him that our relationship is growing and it's getting stronger. I've always been known as a prayer. I love to pray. And I had a guy come. I was going through some things at the house with the county and playing their games. And you know how government is. You just can't. Sometimes you just can't win with it. And I'm going to confess something. But I had to do this to learn what I learned next. And it was so awesome. Because I sat there and I went to work. And I was known that if somebody wanted prayer, I'll pray for them. I don't care. I'm not ashamed of it. So much was going on. I said, Lord, I said, I'm sorry. You know my heart. You know who I am. And you know right now, I'm not saying this in a sense of that I just don't believe that you're real. But I said, I'm feeling so down that right now, I've not heard from you. And the answer is not being answered. That it's hard for me to believe you're real. Because I'm alone. I said, so today, I'm done. I'm not going to pray to you today. And see, I'm one that believes in praying continuously, without ceasing. There's something you can pray for. You know, you see somebody, I don't care, just, Lord, what's that person think? They might be going through something. I tell people sometimes that I know that they're Christians. I tell them, say, hey, I pull them to the side. Hey, if you ain't got nothing to pray about today or you run a little shy on things, remember me and my wife and family. Remember my grandkids. Oh, okay. And anyhow, I sit there and I said, I'm sorry, Lord. I don't mean no disrespect. You know my heart. But it's just hard. We got to admit, sometimes it's hard. I mean, that's the truth. So I went on. Doing my work. 15, 20 minutes later, a guy comes up to me. Hey, I got a question. Hey, what's up? He says, I understand you pray for people. Well, yeah. I had of forgot what I had said. And so I said, do you want me to pray in my private time? Do you want me to pray for you at home? I can pray for you right here on the front dock, because this is at work. I said, we can go around the corner and I can pray for you. He said, let's go around the corner. I said, okay. I kid you not. We go around the corner. I already forgot what I said. But my concern was for what this man was going through. I went around the corner and I prayed for him. And I started praying for him. And it was so cool. Because I started crying. And the reason why I cried, because the Holy Spirit just walked up behind me and just said, if I'm not real, then why are you praying on his behalf? I felt his presence so strong. Now, you might be here tonight and you might be going through some things and you might be young to where you just, I'm going to be here another 100 years or whatever, and you've never experienced the presence of God. I want to tell you, I challenge you, go and seek him out. I am serious, because he will show up like you have never experienced before. Probably within a month of that time, things didn't change. But me and him got closer. And there was one day I went to work and I said, Lord, I can't do nothing. I cannot do nothing but stand here and praise you. And I was up on the front dock of Building 15 at Saddle Creek Corporation in Lakeland. And I said, I'm just going to praise you for everything you've given me, everything you've brought me. And all of a sudden, I felt this presence it's like two wings just went and just pulled me in. And I said, Lord, now, I know that's you, but this is what I've done. I said, I know that's you. I said, but I'm going to move over here, because I'm going to make sure that it's not a breeze passing through. And as soon as I got over there, it's like, I said, okay, Lord, I'm telling you, I'm enjoying this. I'm serious. I'm enjoying it because I know it. The more I moved, the more it became real, the more quicker. And he showed me when we get this block that's in our head from here to up there, get that block out of the way, that he can be quicker to move in our life. I'm going to sing two songs for you, and then I'll close it. That's fine. This one song has been a family favorite for years. One of the last times I heard it was before my brother passed away. And he was never a lead singer. But he can sing baritone. And he can sing tenor. And he didn't have a problem singing to make other people sound good. You see, that's what you're doing. When you're singing baritone or you're singing tenor, you're making the lead, you're bringing it together. And then you got the bass singer, way down there, rock bottom, and it just throws it all together. I love Southern gospel music. I love every style of music more when it gives him praise. But this song has been sung slow all the time that I've heard. But the second verse sounds so much more like a fast praise song, because it's like, oh, I can't believe it. So this is one of the songs that I want to record and put on a CD. I'm going to try and remember it. And I'm a very emotional person. So I'm really fighting back tears and a whole lot right now. So it's one of the things that's just like, but this song, I'm going to do it a cappella, or in Acapulco, they want me to come down and sing it. But it's called What a Day That Will Be. There is coming a day where no heartache shall come, no more clouds in the sky, no more tears to dim
takes me by the hand and leads me through the promised land. What a day, glorious day that will be. There'll be no sorrow there. Oh, no more burdens, no burdens to bear. No more sickness, no more pain, and no more crying over there. And forever I will be, oh, with the one, Lord, died for me. Oh, what a day, glorious day that will be. If you know the chorus, you can sing it with me. What a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see, and I look upon his face. Oh, the one who saved me by his grace. And when he takes me by the hand and leads me through the promised land. Oh, what a day, glorious day. Yes, that will be. Oh, what a day. Glorious day that will be.
Amen. I tell you what, isn't that awesome? See, the one thing that this world has that we don't have is addictions to things that are bad for us. They have a free ticket to a place that's going to burn forever. Just put that on. I'm one of them. I like to make people think. I drive some of the people I work for and work with. I drive them plumb crazy. I had one guy tell me one day, he says, dude, let me ask you something. He said, what if? I said, what if what?
I love that stuff. I'm serious.
He said, what if you go through life and you're a Christian? And then you die. And you're just dead. I said, okay, well, I can answer that question. And he says, okay, I want to hear it. I said, well, if I'm a born-again Christian, I believe what God's word says, that I can live and have life more abundantly. See, that's one of the things a lot of Christians have forgotten, is we're having life more abundantly than what they are. Sorry. But I said, I had life more abundantly. I said, and then one day I die and it's over. So I've lived and I've had a happy life. I've had a good marriage. I've got kids that I love and adore, and they love me because I've treated them what God's said for me to do. My wife loves me because I've been the man that his word says for me to be. And that's fine because I lived a happy life. What's wrong with that? And he said, well, that sounds okay. He said, but you don't, there's no payoff. I said, the whole life was the payoff. I said, now I got a question for you. He said, what's that? I said, what if you go through life and you're chasing every woman that's not your wife, and your kids look at you like you're the meanest, most hateful person in the world, and every day is a burden to you. And you can't get that millions of dollars that this world has made you think that that's what you've got to have to be happy. And then you die after all these years of struggling and trying to make it through, and the temperature starts rising. What do you mean? There's a real hell, and you just found it. And he's like, that's not funny. I'm like, no, you're right. It's not funny. I would rather believe that God sent his son to die on the cross for me. And be counted a fool here on this earth and silly. But you know what? I can tell you, and I can show you a lot of the people that used to laugh at me. They're the first ones that... excuse me. Hey, question for you. Yeah, what's that? Because see, every door, every question is an opening. That's a chance. And plus, I like finding out ways of making a chance of witnessing to people. And you don't have to quote them the whole chapter of John and this and that. You don't have to do that. Let them see the real you, where you came from, where you are now, where you're going. This last song I'm going to sing, if you're here tonight, you've been having some rough times, this is a reminder. If you've doubted your salvation, this is a reminder. If you've got to that point where you're like, man, is it really real? This is a reminder. Now, I'm going to sing this song. And if you feel the need, these altars are open. Pastor, I'll meet you. A lot of churches, it's the same. Nobody gets saved that sings. Nobody dedicates their lives that sings. Nobody prays that sings. God never set that rule. He says, come whenever. I will have to use my glasses for this song. Because I've still not learned all the words, because it's just, 52 is getting close. Y'all have been so awesome tonight, and I thank you for allowing me to come. I'm going to make a couple requests. One, please remember me and my family in prayer, because this is what God's wanted me to do. I've got a full-time job, and he blesses me for my finances. So I don't need love offerings. God has not showed me at any short time in my life that I'm supposed to be going, well, yes, Pastor, I'll be there on that night, but I need $250,000 to be there. Because you know I do others. And he's dead. I can do John Wayne, but I fall a lot. My daddy is Tim, remember Carol Burnett show? Tim Conway? When he would do the old man, my dad would say, go ahead and do that again next time. And you know, he would bust out laughing. And okay, it didn't work though when I was getting in trouble. You know, I couldn't walk in the house handing the report card that had several F's on it going, that didn't work. He'd look at it and go, yeah, no, not funny. But anyhow, y'all pray for us. If you know of churches, let them know. Give me a call. I want to go and share God's word with everyone. Years ago, I said, Lord, I would love to be able to proclaim your name before a million people and tell what you've done. Through his spirit, he said, I'm going to let you do that. But it's going to be one at a time, 20 at a time, 100 at a time. And every time I go before people and sing, and I witness, I'm reminded of that. And it is an awesome experience. So look yourself in the mirror when you get home and say, God, what can I do? And I'm going to tell you, he's going to bless you. Y'all listen to the words of this last song. It was hiding on me. page you got backwards. I'm sorry. So you say he likes to play them games, don't he? Here we go. Thank you, Jesus. He gets all the glory in this anyhow.
When I think of all my faults and all my failures, I am humbled by the grace that I have found.
You know what I think of that? I'm sorry. We will get there. I forgot one line. Now this is going to be obvious.
When I think of all my faults and all my failures, when I consider all the times I let God down,
see, that was important.
I am humbled by the grace He has extended. I'm amazed at the mercy I have found. I can never earn His love on my own. Every time I come before His throne, I stand redeemed by the
Thank you. Each day.